Guys, before I start this video, I just wanted to give you a sneak peek of something I got yesterday in the mail. Look at this. Ta-da! Charlotte Tilbury package. I ordered online this new Charlotte Tilbury flawless filter for a superstar youth glow, and I'm really excited to try it out. But I wanted to ask you if you wanted to see a dedicated video on this bad boy as a first impression demo review. If you want that video, please let me know in the comment below or give me a thumbs up, and I will know that you want to see that video. So now, enough about it, and now back to the main topic, current beauty favorite. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are doing well. Today's video, I'm very excited because it has been a minute that I have done a beauty favorite, like a current beauty favorite. So this is what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna share with you what I've been loving the past few weeks. I just take the best of the best that I've been really, really into it. So if you wanna know what products I've been crazy about, just keep on watching. So first thing first, it's not gonna be a surprise for you, but I've been loving my Smashbox photo primer or photo finish primer water. This is not a surprise, you know I love that. I'm almost done with it, but I will definitely repurchase another one when I will be done with this one. I just love it. I love priming my face with it. I love setting my makeup with it. I also love refreshing my makeup throughout the day with it. I just love it so much, and I really do feel it does something to my makeup, and it's not gimmicky at all. Even though it says primer water, like water, what is it really gonna do to your face? Well, it really does something to it. So I'm just loving it. Smashbox photo primer, a big thumbs up. Now, still with primers, I've been loving another Smashbox primer. This one is the photo finish pore minimizing primer. Every time I do my makeup, I don't know, I just want to use that one. I really do feel it fills in my pore. It really minimize my pore as well, and really give a nice flawless canvas to do my makeup on. So I really do love it. I'm already having a little bit of a dent, even though I still have a lot of products left, but I don't know, I really do love it, and I do feel my pores are really minimized with this primer, definitely. Okay, I promise this is gonna be the last primers I've been loving. I know I've been loving a lot of primer actually, but these two I've been loving, the Becca primers. This one I've been having it for quite some time now, and it's the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I love that it has a luminous finish to it, so it really gives me a beautiful glow to start my makeup. I just love that product so much. It smells good, it sinks into the skin so well, it gives a beautiful glow to your face. Love, love, love that primer. And I have this one, which is freshly new actually. If you have seen my last video, you know that I hold this one, so it's fairly new, but I'm already obsessed with it, and I already see results from this Becca primer. And this one is the First Light Priming Filter, and what it actually does, it gives you an instant complexion refresh base, and it really does it. So it has like a lavender color to it, and it smells citrusy, it smells really, really good, but it really makes my base instantly refreshed, instantly filtered. Really, I really like the result of this one, but these two are really amazing, and I definitely can see myself buying the full size of each because they are doing different things. So seriously, I love them so much. Enough with primers, as I promised. Now we're gonna talk about foundation, and I've been loving, there you go, and I've been loving this stick foundation from Makeup Revolution. It's actually the Ultra HD Invisible Cover Stick Foundation. I talked about this one many, many times on my channel. Lately, I've been loving using it all the time. Like every time I do my makeup, I don't do it every single day, but every time I do it, I just want to wear this foundation. It's just, it gives my face a beautiful base, flawless, perfected. Plus it has this beautiful satin luminous finish that I love. For me, it's like a full coverage foundation for sure, and I love it because it doesn't look like a full coverage at all. It's very natural, very beautiful, very flawless, very radiant. I just love this foundation so much, and it's so easy to apply. It's 2 minutes, I'm done with my base with this foundation. It's so easy, so quick. Just love it, love it, love it, love it. And with this foundation, what I've been loving to use as a makeup tool, it has been this brush right there. It's from Tarte, it's their foundation brush. I love this brush with this foundation. These two together is the heaven combo. This brush is so fluffy, so big, so great, that actually when I use this foundation with it, in 2 minutes, I am done with my makeup. It just saved me so much time, and like, it's so quick for me. I don't have to think about if I have enough coverage or if it's blend out properly, because this does the work so well, so quick, so beautifully. I just love these two together, and this brush goes well with liquid foundation, with powder foundation, with cream foundation. I just love it so much. Speaking of tool, I've been loving this makeup sponge. Sorry for this sponge to be dirty, but I used it today. Guys, since I got this sponge from EcoTool, which is a drugstore brand, so affordable price, I haven't touched my beauty blender once. Like my black beauty blender, I haven't touched it once since I got this sponge. I just love this sponge so much because I can do so much with it. First of all, it's very squishy, very easy to use. Plus it has like two sides, one big flat, one small flat. I love using this big flat to blend out my concealer. I love using this small flat to apply my setting powder, and obviously I love using this bottom of this sponge for my foundation, but also for my cream contour. I love, 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 love this foundation so much. It saved me so much time as well, and I just love it. So I will definitely repurchase another one when this one will be completely done, but highly recommend the EcoTool sponge if you never tried, because it's really, really good. Now, I really want to talk about concealers that I've been loving. So as no surprise, I've been loving my Makeup Revolution concealer. I have been loving them so much. I use them all the time. Every time I do my makeup and I do my concealer, my highlight and my contour, I use these three bad boys right there. I've got the shade C4 to brighten my under eye and my T-zone. I've got the shade C5 to conceal my dark circle, and I've got the shade C14 to contour my face. Seriously, if you never tried them, have to try them out. They are just £4 each, so it's a bargain. The quality is there, it's amazing. It's blend out so well, it's full coverage, so it really does cover your dark circle really, really well. I feel like it's even flawless. It doesn't settle into my fine lines. It doesn't crease as well throughout the day. So if you never tried them, go to Superdrug. You can order them on tambeauty.com. You're gonna love them and you're gonna thank me later. Speaking of setting powder, there's a powder lately that I've been completely obsessed with, and this is no surprise, the Too Faced Born This Way setting powder. Just love it. Amazing powder, very finely made, beautiful on the skin, flawless, brightens, blur the imperfection, doesn't settle into the fine line, set the concealer beautifully, set your entire face amazingly. I know I'm being extra, but I love it so much. I love the packaging. It's very chic, very beautiful, very luxurious. And plus you've got so much product in it, so I think it's gonna last you for quite some time. It really makes your face flawless, perfected, and it just beautiful. So this powder, you have to try it out. If you are not into powder because you think it may make your face cakey, this one won't do that at all. It's gonna make your face beautiful and it's gonna make your makeup last longer for sure. Highlighter. I've been loving few highlighters lately, but one have stand out to me for sure, and this one is from Smashbox as well, and it's the collaboration with Casey Holmes. I love that highlighter so much. This is the packaging. I know, weird, huh? I keep the packaging for most of my favorite items. I don't know why. Do you do that as well? Do you keep the packaging as well? I don't know. It's too beautiful to throw it away, so I don't know. I want to keep it. But anyway, we're talking about this highlight right there. Beautiful. The perfect trio for me, for my skin tone. I just love it. I mainly use the champagne shade right there usually, but I know for summertime I will definitely be using these two together. They are beautiful, they are very pigmented though, so you have to be careful, but they are just stunning. They're not patchy, they are really beautiful on the skin. They even look a bit wet on the skin. So it's the Spotlight palette in the shade Pearl. I love the packaging, Smashbox packaging, so this is just stunning as well. Beautiful, highly recommended. Mascara, yes, I've been loving this Maybelline Temptation mascara. This mascara really stand out to me. It's been really great on my lashes. I feel like it really gives some volume to it. It doesn't clump into my lashes as well. It stays on all day long, so it doesn't flake under my eyes. It's just a beautiful, beautiful mascara. I like the brush as well. It's like a normal brush, I wanna say. Really great, really nice, affordable from the drugstore. So if you're looking for a good mascara to try out, you can try this one. It's a really good one to try. Plus, I didn't say it smells coconut. Well, it's supposed to smell coconut, but for me, it doesn't smell coconut. But for others, it does smell coconut. So maybe for you, it will smell coconut. It's infused actually with coconut and also with castor oil. So it's great for your lashes because castor oil is well known to just improve the length of your lashes, and the coconut oil is well known to moisturize and hydrate your lashes. So a really nice combo to find in this mascara. Let's talk about an eyeshadow palette I've been loving, and I have been using other eyeshadow palettes as well along this past few weeks and months, but the one that I really reach out the most is the Huda Beauty Obsession, and it's actually the warm brown obsession. Again, I kept the little plastic here. I'm sorry, I can't help myself, but this is just stunning. I love the packaging. It's beautiful. It's like in 3D, I wanna say. You can see the reflect of the shimmery eyeshadow here. It's beautiful, and when you open it, ta-da, here's the beauty right there. Look at these shadows, guys. They are my favorite kind of shadow to wear. They are warm, they are brown, they are a bit rusty, reddish, purplish. So you have warm tone, you have cool tone, you have this beautiful star of the show right there, which is a beautiful bronzy shimmery shade, which is very, very pigmented, guys. So this is like everything you need for a beautiful warm eye look. I just love this palette so much. It has a really nice size mirror as well, so it's great for traveling. If you are a warm lover, you have everything you need for a warm eye look, definitely. And plus, you can do also some cool tone as well if you want. You can do smoky, you can do natural look, night look, anything you want, you can do it with this palette here. I just love it so much. And guys, the pigmentation doesn't lie. It's right there. This is how good it is. It's really good. I highly recommend one of these palettes. If you are not a warm lover, you have a cool eyeshadow palette as well. You have a smoky eyeshadow palette as well. But this one, guys, I love it. Mwah. I love it. All right, let's talk now about lipstick. I've been loving the L'Oreal Color Shine Rich Lipstick. If you didn't try these ones, I have three shades right there. They're amazing. I've got a pinky shade, which is 112 only in Paris. Well, I'm gonna say it in French. Only in Paris. We don't say the S in Paris, we said Paris. So only in Paris, and this is a beautiful pink. I just love it, with the shine, as you can see, very glossy, very balmy. These lipsticks are amazing, very hydrated as well. So for summertime, it's just the perfect kind of formula to have. This one is the 642 MLBB, which is My Lips But Better, and it's a beautiful, beautiful nude. I just love that nude so much right there, and reminds me so much of my beloved Yves Saint Laurent number 44, my favorite nude ever. So if you don't want to splurge on a luxury lip balm, lipstick, try this one out, because it's nearly the same. So seriously, it's a bargain, it's under 10 pounds. So yeah, try it out. The last one, but not the least, is the 464 Color Hype. And this one is a beautiful bright color. And look at this vibrant color. I really want like a coral shade as well, so I will pick another one for sure, and it's gonna be a coral peach shade. But these three shades right there, they are beautiful, they are very glossy, very shiny, they are very, very comfortable, very glossy, very beautiful, very hydrated, and very pigmented for a lip balm lipstick kind of thing. So definitely try them out. They have a variety of shades, so if these are not your kind of colors, they have black, they have purple, they have red, coral, peachy, brown, any color you may think of, they have it. And the last but not the least, I want to talk about nail polish. I have been loving the L'Oreal nail polish. They called, I believe, L'Oreal Color Rich Nail Polish, if I'm not wrong. I have few of them now. I have a pink, I have a gray one, which I'm wearing today. I have a top coat, and these two are by far my favorite ones. I have a magenta red one right there, which is called 552 Ruby Folie, and this one is a beautiful autumnal shade, more like a pumpkin orangey shade. I love that one so much as well. This one is the 446 Rouge Opéra. So it says Rouge Opéra. Rouge means red in French. It's not really red, huh? It's more pumpkin than red. I love these two so much. They are my favorite ones. I love the formula. They are very pigmented as well. I've been wearing them a lot. And there you go, guys, we are done with my current beauty favorite. I hope you liked it. I hope you have been inspired to try some of the products I've been loving. If you do have favorites, I would love to know them as well. So please let us know about them in the comment below. So if you did like this video, please give a thumbs up, share and subscribe if you haven't already. And I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Until then, stay beautiful. Mwah. Bye.